Lots of new details released about the new Star Trek show, and not all of them are favorable.
The World According to Jon.
My name is Jonathan Paula, and welcome to this audio-only version of The World According to Jon. Think of it as a fancy podcast slideshow, and not because I was too lazy to film in 95-degree heat. All right, so yesterday night at the Television Critics Association, producer Bryan Fuller unleashed a lot of new details and information about the new Star Trek show, Star Trek Discovery, which premieres next January 2017 on CBS All Access, which is an internet-only platform you have to pay $6 a month to watch. In addition to that $6 a month subscription fee, you also have to watch 12 minutes of ad per hour. Wow, I cannot believe they screwed this up so badly. I get that CBS wants to try to compete with Netflix, Amazon, and Hulu. I get it. I think they're going to fail badly. Like, Netflix and Amazon own this space. CBS, don't even bother trying. And especially don't bother trying if you're going to cram in 12 minutes of advertisements per hour as well as the subscription fee. Who's gonna wanna sit through that when you're already paying money? It's stupid. And more proof that the old white men running America's quote-unquote most watched network have no idea what actual viewers want out of their viewing experience. They can churn out as many NCIS's and Big Bang Theories as they want, but when it comes right down to it, people wanna see stuff like Stranger Things. Good. Ad-free, strongly written, serialized content with realistic characters. But I'm hopeful we get a little bit of that with Star Trek Discovery, because it was announced that its first season of 13 episodes would be serialized, which means that there would be one overarching plot that goes through all the episodes, which is a huge departure from all the existing Star Trek TV shows, which were very episodic. Every episode had a beginning, middle, and end, and it very, very rarely sort of carried over to future installments. We also know, perhaps the biggest news out of this announcement from Bryan Fuller, is that Star Trek Discovery will be set in the Prime Universe, unrelated to J.J. Abrams' movie reboots, and it will be set 10 years prior to Captain Kirk's five-year mission in the original 1960s TV series. So we're getting yet another prequel. And because it's just 10 years before Kirk, I feel like we're going to see those green and yellow tunics again, the mini skirts. We're going to have all the old sound effects and sets, which, I mean, I get it. Like, that's the most iconic and most recognizable era of Trek, and they want to keep going back to that well. But we've already had two prequels in the form of the movie and the Enterprise TV show from the early 21st century, and now we're going back there again. As a longtime fan of Trek, I'm disappointed. I was really hopeful they were going to go post-Nemesis, post-Star Trek Voyager, and do basically like a next generation. I want to pick things up in the 25th century. Let's go forward 50 or 80 years past the events of Captain Picard and figure out what's going on with the Federation, you know, way, way out in the future when everyone else we know is dead. And maybe we get some appearances from, I don't know, a very, very old Captain Riker or something. I think that'd be cool. Kind of the same thing you do with Next Generation. You had some cameo appearances from the old cast by some clever writing. Either they're really old or they're stuck in some time loop transporter accident. But by making it a prequel, you cut all of those possibilities off at the head, and it really limits what you're able to do creatively because we know where the show has to end. To that end, Fuller also explained that Discovery is going to examine some of the events mentioned in previous iterations of Trek but never fully explored. So what are the events that took place between Star Trek Enterprise and Star Trek The Original Series? We have the outbreak of the Klingon Federation War, wherever the Tribbles came from, some stuff with the Elorians and the Nexus from Star Trek Generations. All of that stuff is somewhere in the beginning of the 23rd century, or 22nd century. I don't know my timelines well. We also know that Discovery is going to have a female lead in the show, but she's not going to be the captain, but a lieutenant commander with, quote, caveats. So we're having a show where the captain is not the main character. I like that idea in premise, but inherently, the captain was never the main character in any of the shows. They were a central figure, yes, but everyone got sort of equal billing and had an equal amount of episodes. It was the movies, I think, that really sort of disproportionately focused on the captain of each respective crew. But let's move on. They're absolutely going to be having a gay character. I think it's about time. The show is about inclusion, it's about equality, and it's about diversity. The first show famously had an African-American woman and a Russian during the middle of the Cold War and the Civil Rights Crisis. That was a huge deal, and I think this is 2000. 2017, we can probably have a homosexual character on television in a sci-fi drama set 400 years in the future without freaking out too much. So I like that. I hope they don't make a big deal out of it and like, hey, look, everyone, this guy's gay. Like, just have him be gay, just like we had Uhura be black. And it was sort of nobody really paid any attention to it because it's not a big deal to these characters in that timeline. We also know that there's going to be a lot of alien characters, one of them named Saru, possibly Spock's mother, Amanda Grayson, will be featured, and there's going to be lots of robots. Again, make of that what you will. I think that just screams Star Trek, lots of different characters and different places and backgrounds coming together. And I think if they have strong, serialized writing over this 13 episodes, it could be really strong. It could be really compelling. If CBS doesn't totally bungle it up with the rollout on this CBS All Access platform, which I don't know if it's going to do very well, even with a juggernaut property like Star Trek leading the way for it. Those are my thoughts. Lots to take in. From what I understand, we're going to have more details, maybe even some footage, as early as October. And being the massive Trek fan that I am, you'll probably hear me talk about them here on John's World. Also, make sure to check out the Jogwheel channel. All this month, I'm reviewing every one of the 13 Star Trek films on movie night, spending a lot of time making these episodes, so it would mean a lot if you went and checked them out. Link in the description below. But that will do it for this podcasty episode of The World According to Jon. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. But until next time, that does it for me. Thank you for watching and listening. I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.